So I was just delaying coming on the stream there because I realised I hadn't uploaded the last couple of streams to the gaming channel. Like, I wouldn't have remembered what number I've got to do there, but I think I was on like 16 machines, because I think it was on like 10 machines or 12 machines. Yeah, 12 machines looks about right. So then I would have been going through the numbers until it got on the 3 per minute value of the recipe. So these two are facing the wrong way. And then this one's facing the right way. Making sure that's on the right belt speed as well. Alright, now this ship, am I gonna need to add a third stage to it? So times 90 times 8. So yeah, we'll be able to get away with two sets of Mark V still. So we should have 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. Still Mark One. This bit's going to be easy if I just go and check the signage rather than doing math on the machines themselves. Because I might need to expand these manifolds, I might just need to reclock them. Right, so we need 42.375. Divided by 3. I'm going to double check that the signage out front's been updated. Yep. And then that's 101. So yeah, the signage is up to date. So let's look at the silica first. 37.5, so we need 15. And we have 11. I don't really need to count out the parts there, because I can just top up stacks of shit and then go and get a reasonable amount of cable. Double checking that I'm not gonna like end up with a random stack of 5 there. Get rid of some of these parts. Just keeping some of those just in case, like, it comes up in crash sites again, as it has previously. Some Mark II as well before we pop back up, and we should probably get some concrete while we're down here. I mean, at this point I could reclock some steel shit, but because I'm still doing the pass on making sure everything's supplied correctly, I don't want to have to come back later. Because we've already established that we've messed some of the numbers up. Well, we've messed some of the numbers up, not in this case. In this case, we're increasing production to account for a recipe switch. we might need to make multiple trips for plates if we're doing building expansion. But given that we're currently in this facility where the plates are being produced, not really an issue. Possibly could have collected more Mark III belt parts while I was there. Whoops. Yeah, we've got none stashed. We need 15. I'm just taking the lazy option here. That needs to be Mark IV. This is where we go get more Mark IV and III belt parts. Really don't need that amount of mortar on me. Apparently, I misspelled quartz, and I've only just... Whoop. I've only just noticed now. Like, distracted by the typo there. Yeah. So the intent with that task is, I'm just gonna, like, go to the other end and ride the belt. 4. Which one of these was intended to be my silica leg? Was it the bottom one? I think it was. Because we've got circuit board there, a quick wire there, and then that's empty. So that means this will need upgrading to Mark 5. Run straight through that one. buy this shit in, haven't we? Crate to collect. It's really weird how, like, the lighting just flips like that. Right, so we're going to have 8 constructors a piece, clocked at 9. Oh, right, because that's wrong. So the divided by 90, that's how much each manufacturer needs, but these are cactus, so we need 11. Divided by 60. That's how much, there we go. So let's double check these. This should be 9. Yep, so we need 2 more either side. Oh, that was a already clocked one, so whoopsie. Probably afford to trash that. Oh, we're doing these in pairs, right. Wiring this up backwards, because normally I'd do from like the straight line up before I wire the machines in. Yucky dokey. Right, what do we want here? So we want 11 times 12. Well, 12 times this times 11. That's a Mark three. To do Mark 3 down here just because it's slightly over Mark 2. Although there is a point at which I could have left the Mark 2 in place. The way I do manifold, I prefer to have them consistent all the way down. one of the Caterium lines is here. Goes up higher than that. So hopefully on the next playthrough we've got to learn that this particular manifold needs to be belted a little bit better than this nonsense. that should be all rebalanced. Alright, yeah, we can rebuild this a little bit. There we go. Now this remains the margin tile. We can actually pull this in. I'm like, oh, what's that tile doing there? That's the initial spawn point for this razor. So I keep forgetting I do that. Like, one of the things that I think would be, like, interesting would be if the initial drop pod wasn't recycled to make the hub parts, because then that would serve as the initial spawn point for the entire game. Well, that would mean that the there wouldn't be like a place where I could stick a foundation tile down. That probably explains how I end up with holes in the middle of my floors. Just forgetting to fill shit in like that. Yeah, there's this whole thing with crash sites not currently being dismantleable. So if the drop pod doesn't need to be dismantled when you start the game in order to get the hub parts, it would then follow that you could make it a R&D feature to be able to dismantle crash sites, which would then let you dismantle the drop pod as well. There we go! Expansion done! We should update the side signage. So we've got 15.15625 plus 42.375 plus 3. So one strategy that I could try for the next playthrough is calculating all of these manifolds to the maximum clock speed needed for each destination. So then I only need to dismantle an underclock rather than expand at this stage in the game. Okay, so 60.53125. Divided by 3 times 90, 18, 15.9375. Oh, 15. Right, so that belt won't need adjusting, so it should already be Mark 4. Yeah. Times 37.5 divided by 37.5 times 22.5. I know we're doing this backwards, but the, you know, placeholders for the math are already there. So 453984375. And like, this is like one of the reasons why I like to have like the signage here, because if I know in advance that I'm gonna need like that amount of silica by the end of my game, then I'm more likely to want to ship stuff like limestone as well in order to make inline or multi-stage, probably, cheap silica. Now, of course, early on in the game, if I'm doing multi-stage or in like inline, either way, with multi-stage, that would mean there would be one belt per manifold rather than having a single Mark 5 belt. Where if it was like a creative mode playthrough, where I have access to all of the belts at the start, then I could just do it optimal from the get-go. And then we copy over that number to there, because it's 1-1. Right, notepad time. Copied in. Okay, so queuing it 363.1875, and then 453.984375, and raw quartz is already on the notepad. Yeah, upgrade RCU quartz to Mark 4. We've also got to now upgrade high speed connector to Mark 4. I've still got the headroom there. Alright, so I just updated radio control unit, which means we would have been over this side. Looking at numbers and shit. So that's external, and that's external. Seeing computer, warehouse only. Yep, yep. Front 28125 here. Yes. And now we wait. Supply number is correct. We've already checked AI limit of numbers, so yeah, we all good here. So supercomputer. Now, as long as that is 9, we don't need to go check anything else. Yep. Check stator and oh shit, we should check high speed connector numbers first because we were just there. There. See, it's one of these things where, because this is such a low profile item, I can't see from down here that there's anything on it. Stainer. Right. Do. data, she needs 30.315. Yep, we good there. So the high speed connector resources, which we've already reclocked, are external, so we go up to the next floor. Those are external. So now we gotta check on turbo motor. Which we were just faffing around with by switching recipes. Motor 6.5 bar, RTU. Cooling units flagged for removal. I've just increased production so I can mark that off my notepad. Oh, I don't have rotor noted down, that's a bit weird. So we want 6.5 bloody blah for rotor. Alright, that's good. And these are external resources, so we don't need to follow those back. Needs underclocking, which will have knock-on effects, and we'll have further knock-on effects when we go just cooling system. So this needs knocking down to 6.5625. Divided by 2. Item 5, 7.5 times 3.75. So, well, that's not that much different. Bloop. Right. 34.3125. Signage. There we go. Propagate this. Blah, 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 blah. We go propagate this change. So 4.3125. Times by 195. Divide by 260. Sixty-eight point six two five. 594.75. Right, and that is 5.75. Right, and that is steel, so that'll need to be reclocked. Oh, I was getting confused for a moment. Like, there's a, I'm sure there's a flaw I've got somewhere around here where it's either wire or copper sheet that's multi-stage production and mezzanine load balanced. But like, it's the steel that's mezzanined here. 6.5625 plus 34.325. Plus 11.25, 52.125. Yeah, I remember that number correctly. So 104.25. And 5903.5. And this is the bit where I look it up on the wiki, because I think it's 5 beams per screw. Well, not per screw, 5 beam per 260 screw. So let's double check that. Yes, so 17.375. steel ingot. Divided by 15 times by 60, so 69.5. Divided by 60 times by 40, so 46.3 recurring. Leaving that one overclock first. So we're doing the beams of two constructors. So 17.375. There's the wake up alarm. 34.75. So let's get the notepad updated. Might be doing multiple trips on this one. Let's see, 52.125 for total production, 104.25 for published sheet, 46.3. IPM iron, same for coal, and then we note down the steel so we don't have to do math later. Done the radio control unit. So now we go check on the numbers for electromagnetic control rod. Oh, hang on a second, we were just on motor because we were just doing rotor, aren't we? Which means there'll be two electromagnetic control rod things to check on the status of. Apparently I don't have electromagnetic control rod noted on here. Am I misreading? No, I don't have it noted down. Whoopsie. So 4.6875 UPM electromagnetic control rod. Up to date, that number is also up to date, so nothing to change over here. Before I come back up here, let's double check all of the resources there, because we noticed we forgot to note down that. So I think I was just checking on the rotor for turbo motor before I moved up to motor, so I want to double check that one. Just checking motor numbers, so let's make sure the side signage is up to date, because you know, short term memory is a bit pants at the moment. Alright, so turbo motor, we have checked the rotor, the motor, and the electromagnetic control rod. We've remembered that we did the RCU because that led to this whole expansion nonsense. So we've just checked motor's parts. I will just double check 34 point bloody blah for motor rotor. We check stator numbers. Nothing external here, so we just check the notepads up to date. needlessly had 53.66 IUPM, but it doesn't need to be two digits there. Right, Rockool here, and then I think we're good on Rotor as well, because we've just been checking everything there, so. Now we do the frame and plate facility. Right, internal resources, we know we need to expand that. Let's check the notepads up to date. Yep. Oh, that's a reduction, not an increase. Okay, that's cool. 3.375 divided by 2.8125 times 7.5, so that's 9. So this gets set to 60%. So there's a separate manifold of steel pipe. So we've got 40.5. Oh, it's not a separate manifold. Am I making my own modular frame? Oh no, it's for the encased beam things. Right, okay. But it is a separate... Yeah, it's a separate manifold for... steel pipe. For, well, steel pipe versus beam. So we need to add up these two. That's plus, not multiply. Two, three, four, five, divided by five, so 14.85. We'll have to fix that foundry there as well. 9.25 plus 9.375. Divided by 7. Divided by 4. So 73.6608. Look up in case industrial beam, divide that by 6 times by not 24. I'm looking at the wrong recipe. It's got to add steel beam up still. So divide by 4 and times by 28. Two, three, four, five. Divide by 5. Okay, so we'll need to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we need to add 3 more to the end here. Okay, so margin tile there. Margin tile there. And this is where we run into problems. So one way to address this is we split the total pipe production needed over both of these, and then we run a splitter out. So, fortunately we have like a thing around the side for that. Got 3.375 plus 2.8125, 6.875. Divided by 2.8125 times 7.5, so 16.5. Five. 625. So we got 20.65 divided by 4. Times by 28, 144.375. So if I did 144.375 plus 74.25 divided by 15, then it would bring it under the per machine count. So let's look at doing it that way. Divided by 4 times 20, so 103.125. And divide that by 20 times by 30, so 327.9375. Times by 40, 218.625. So, yeah, 218.65 divided by 15, divided by 20. I think my lesson learned here is the bauxite viaduct just comes straight out the front. Like, straight out the front of there and go right rather than come straight out of here and then, well, from this perspective it's also going right. because we kind of ran into this issue a little bit on the previous playthrough. Although this is the first time we've identified it actually inhibiting, not so much inhibiting production, it's dictating production. Right, so I need to merge these two production lines together. Split it back up again. So I need to go back and check what numbers we've got on the belts. Yeah, Mark 3 is still good. We fill this wall back in. Now we need to re-clock this ship. .9375 divided by 7. Yep, that's good. .08.0804. The notepad. So we got 6.1875 total production, 218.625 iron ingot, 218.625 coal. So down the steel ingots. 327.9375 PM steel. Modular frame. Three point one two five plus 45.375 148.5 concrete. And now we recalculate this as if it was flexible frame. Because we, I think we have that recipe now. Yeah. So we got 6.1875 divided by, well, 6.1875 minus 2.8125 plus 3.75 divided by 3.75 times 18.75. So big increase in, well, relatively speaking, big increase in modular frame. I think I already looked at this and knocked it off because I was going about and deployed the deed reinforced iron plate, and I've got a vague recollection of adding something and immediately removing it. So we've got 8.75 there, 11.25. Not that much of an increase on encased beam, but that will have a reduction in steel. Although, we can check that against the amount of screws. So, so you divide by 15 times 60, so we've got 57 steel ingot for the screws required. So yeah, it would have a reduction in steel. And then we do this again. 6.1875 minus 2.8125 plus 3.75 divided by 3.75 times 75, so 142.5 rubber. So putting that down on the notepad, but I'm going to flag it as remove production. Because I don't think that the corresponding increase in steel by increasing modular frame would be a good idea. Anything else internal for fuse modular frame? Nope. We do have that being internal though, so fortunately it's on the next floor up. This isn't going anywhere internal other than that, so. Yep. This gets set to 16.5. That's 11. Divided by 12 divided by 3. This would be something that would be better suited for multi-stage production, just because of the relatively low volumes of reinforced iron plate. Although the relatively low volumes would also be an excuse to bring in the resources directly as well. Because we've already got iron and coal coming in, so we may as well bring in some plastic for a steel coated plate and some rubber for adhered plate, some copper ingots for stitch plate. And I think that would be pretty much everything, because you know, if you're doing bolted frame or riveted, well, it's not riveted frame, doing bolted frame or default, bolted plate or default plate, you're still going to have steel for that. How much steel pipe is that? It's background media time. Oh, yeah, we've still got to do the steel ingots. Times 30 divided by 60. That feels like that took less time than expected. Did I miss one? Okay, no. Well, then that's that done then. Alright, so we got 16.5 plus 3, so we're at 19.5. Five total production, and now we note down the steel ingots. Right, 13 reinforced iron plate, 65 coal and iron. Okay. Heavy metal frame doesn't presently have anything else internal. So the next thing we'll check in is that, coincidentally. Oh, this is where we were going to switch it to rubber as well, so I'm just going to pop the music off while I'm checking on this shit. Right, okay, so we already have rubber coming in, that's good. So we are only going to be changing these two manifolds. And we're going to be taking out the stitched things. So, yeah, we want to have a bin and a sink. focus on cleaning things up one at a time. Okay, let's go get the hover pack, because... doing this from the ground level is tedious. Save to finish. Oh yeah, we can remove that now. Because that was there. I was wondering what that was there for. It's like, oh, that will have been there for the crystal oscillator. Yeah, Mark IIIs will do it. Reminds me of a Tesla valve, that. Yeah, this seems to be like a more tedious but cleaner way of draining splitter manifolds. Oh, that'll still have a copper ingot in from back when it was doing crystal oscillator. Oopsie. good chance there's a bunch of other manifolds like that, to be honest. Reinforced iron plate. Getting switch to adhered plate for the iron plate reduction. So this is getting set to 3.75, which is 11.25. Iron plate and 3.75 rubber. So 13 divided by 3.75 times 11.25. So 39 iron plate. And 3.75 rubber, so 13 rubber. Oh yeah, it's one rubber. I haven't twigged that. So let's update the side signage. 2.75, 16.75. .75 going to warehouse. Keep forgetting it's 1 to 1. So before we update the side, before we update the notepad, we need to do the belting and update everything else. So this only needs to be Mark 1 now. And similarly, Mark 1 for rubber. Although we're going to leave the Mark 2 supply belting in because, you know, it'd be a little bit better. And obviously if the manifold belt is Mark 1, if the manifold supply belt's Mark 1, then the individual manifold's belt is going to be Mark 1 as well, because you can't get lower than that at present. Double check this for copper ingots if I've made a mistake there. Yeah, either way works. Not this exit, it's this exit I want to look at. So we've got 13 divided by 5. So I want to be doing 2.6 adhered iron plate per machine. Okay, we're good there. Okay, now we update signage. No, we've already updated that. Now we update notepad. Right, let's see, we've got to make. Yeah, we should make sure that the iron and coal production's removed, and that's not just leftovers. Double check iron ingot for reinforced iron plate has been removed. That's on there. So we got 16.75 rubber and 50.25 iron plate needed. And then 16.75 total production. Recipe, yeah, it's no recipe or belt change, you see, so we're just underclocking. So 25.125 divided by 45 times 100, 55.8334. 6.9792. Yes. So 15.875. Three recurring. Divided by 60 times 40, so it's that same number again. So we got 95.25 total. UPM steel. Copy that into the notepad. Just got the same across the board. There we go. Okie dokie, for now. The notepad's all up to date, the signage is all up to date, and all of the internal production is up to date. Not counting stuff that has back and forth effects like queuing system and motor. Alright, as near as I can remember, there are no steel parts that go over to there. But if the steel parts involved in the production chain on motor, we don't want to do steel parts next. Because if we have to adjust motor for cooling system, then we'll have to like come back and do shit again. So, yeah. So I think the next facility we want to do is the ingot facility. I don't think there's anything... Oh, there's not much going from the ingot facility to the plastic facility. So I think it's pretty much only empty canister returns, empty tank returns, and gas filter parts that are heading south from there-ish. So yeah, we're going to do the ingot facility next. But also, the relatively low consumption of resources now illustrates that we could get away with doing nitric acid in here so long as we could get water up. Ooh, actually, before we go anywhere, I should make sure I have an adequate amount of concrete coming in. I want to count how many manufacturers I've got first. Not no manufacturers, constructors. So we've got 1, 2, 3. And yes, we do have some coming in from the west. Big bank of constructors over here. So we got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, let's just hover pack and dismantle count. Okay, so we have 14 total. So 148.5 divided by 14. Divided by 15 total. So we got 70.7143. Whoops. And that relates to the feature request I put in for having UI access to the clipboard buffer. Let's see. Additional use case from today's stream experiment. Removing a recipe from clipboard buffer would mean not accidentally pasting quickwire onto a concrete constructor. Update that on Discord as well. So the issue there was because my muscle memory repetitive action WotSits was having us go press E, open UI, click Control C, blah 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 blah, and I press Control V too soon. I ended up pasting the wrong recipe in. So if we take and copy that clocking before I head back. So if I take this times 45 and then times that by 11. So is that Mark 4 already? Yes. So we need 350 unit a minute of limestone coming in here. And that's spread over 3 miners. So we have a normal... So those two are going to be clocked the same. And as long as this other miner is also normal, that's going to be even across the board. Cool. So we can now divide that by 3. And divided by 120. So you get 97.2322. On Discord again. Very teeny tiny piece. I'm not sure, like, I've seen other, like, tiny details like that. Is that a light fitting? Or is that, like, an intake for something else? So it looks like something that crimps an input. Anyway. Right, now we go change the clocking on the 3 remaining ones. Well, the first thing I did was I wanted to make sure the belt's adequate. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's good. Then 11 times 10.7. Yeah, that's more than adequate. I completely forgot to copy the number. After I said I was going to copy the number. Yes, I had a terrible version of the idea I posted about being able to edit the clipboard. So the idea there was still having a UI to edit the clipboard. Terrible version is being able to edit the clipboard buffer via the blueprint designer. Then what you end up with is you open like a special tab in the blueprint designer, say load clipboard item and edit it. I'm gonna put a comment on for that one. We could reduce power consumption further by pulling in more limestone nodes. But at this point, it's not really going to be worth it. Right. Times 45 times 3. By 120 times 100, 79.5536. So that means this facility is largely okay. I don't know if the concrete counts as an external resource because of how it's distributed over two places rather than just downstairs. Thank you. So I think what the plan's going to be here is I take a brief break. And I come and like do the ingot factory reclocking over here. And I just realised I need to put a note on the notepad to say remove copper ingot production for reinforced iron plate. Let's get that saved. Right. Yeah, so I'm gonna be like back on probably before noon, because I'm gonna have an early lunch, because I've been up early, so we'll see what happens. So that's gonna be off now. Thanks for watching, goodbye.